26-year-old Gary Rowland from Warrington is greedy, never exercises, and is unashamed of his eating habits.
Sometimes when we have things like strawberries and cream, I'll just take out the strawberries and I can just have a bowl of cream instead.
Feisty Amarine Iqbal from Fife knows she's a beast, but can't bear to deny herself.
This is our Scottish drink, one of my favourite fizzy drinks. It's a good Scottish delicacy, I think.
They claim they're desperate to shift their excess baggage, but use any excuse to keep up their bad habits.
Well, some people smoke all the time, some people drink all the time, I eat all the time.
So to shock them into making a drastic change, they're flying to the Greek island of Crete, one of the fattest parts in Europe, to live with a catastrophically overweight family.
He's absolutely massive. He could just drop dead from a heart attack.
If she goes like the way she is going now, she won't be alive by the time she's 20.
Immersing themselves in their Greek host's lives, they'll eat what they eat.
Oh my God. Oh no.
You eat lamb's balls.
And get drawn into long-standing family feuds around weight and diet.
I think you are in denial.
The more you push, the more I will push back.
You're a 40-year-old child.
I don't like the torture, that's why.
You know why? Because truth hurts.
They'll learn how Greece's classic Mediterranean diet has declined into one of processed fast food.
Someone's got to literally shake them and say, get a grip.
It just proves that she's so defiant towards wanting to change her lifestyle.
As the gloves come off, will the pressure prove too much for Gary and Amarine?
We need to go home. That's what we need to do.
Okay.
Just go home.
Snack-loving Gary is single and wasn't always overweight.
I think really, the way I see myself is probably just like a bit of a potato.
In the last 7 years, his weight's ballooned and he's now a whopping 19 and a half stone.
I am addicted to food. If I start eating, I won't be able to stop eating them for the rest of the day, even to the point of feeling sick. Chips, cheese and gravy, please. Sometimes, even when I've had my dinner, I'll still feel a little bit hungry, so I might just pop out and get something else to eat from the takeaway.
Gary's job in a call centre means he gets no exercise during the day, and even less at night.
When I get home from work, just sit downstairs until I have to go to bed. I just think, I can't be bothered even going upstairs because it just puts me out of breath.
A messy breakup 2 years ago left Gary's confidence in tatters.
When Gary split up with this particular guy, he turned to Gary and was like, well, what are you doing splitting up with me? Like, look at the state of you, like you're gonna get anybody else.
His weight's taking all the fun out of his life.
Last year we went to Alton Towers. One particular ride, he couldn't fit in and he was embarrassed. I could see how he was hurt. And I really felt for it.
See you later.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Despite living 5 minutes away from his family, Gary avoids spending time with them.
It is quite upsetting when we have meals together as a family that everyone's really slim and I'm the big one at the table.
Gary wishes things were different, but he's stuck in a downward spiral.
While I'm eating the food, it makes me feel better. As soon as I swallowed the last mouthful, I regret what I've just done.
This self-loathing is holding him back from meeting the man of his dreams.
He'll say things to me like, oh, I'm going to be on my own for the rest of my life, or who wants a fat gay man, and things like that. Gary needs to lose the weight to be happy.
If Gary's going to change, it's now or never.
I do feel that I've tried everything I can to lose weight on my own. I think I'm on the tipping point at the moment, and I think if I do go over 19 and a half, it's... The journey back will be so difficult, I won't even bother trying.
Straight talking Scott Amarine is 5'1" and 15 stone.
I love loving my mum's Punjabi food.
She loves food, Punjabi, it's awful.
She lives with her husband, but her mum and dad live next door, so there's no escaping late night family feasts.
Living in a Muslim household is quite hard because if you're trying to lose weight,
they'll think something's wrong with you.
We're all overweight. We like to eat the foods that we were brought up with.
It doesn't help our size at all, because if you're trying to stay healthy, It is rude not to eat it.
Amarine's husband of 2 years runs a sweet shop, so there's no getting away from the temptation of snacking.
I like coming here because I don't have to pay for some of the food.
Afternoon, coming here all the time, eating crepes.
Baba, it's crisps.
Too much eating.
At 19, Amarine's desperate to start her own family.
I would love to have children. I would either want 3 or 7. But if I'm still the weight that I am, or get any worse, then it'll be really, really hard for me to have kids in the future.
Amarine's been diagnosed with polycystic ovaries, a syndrome that commonly causes infertility and can be exacerbated by obesity.
Well, I don't get my periods regularly. I only get them about twice a year, and I went to see the doctor about it, and he says it's because of my weight. In the future, when I want to have kids, if I'm still the weight I am, if I don't get my periods, it'll be really, really hard for me to conceive.
Hi, I'm Gary.
I'm Amarine.
Hi, Amarine, you all right?
Yeah.
Good.
In an attempt to motivate Amarine and Gary to take control of their weight, they'll be spending the next week living with an obese family in Crete, Greece's biggest island, where they'll witness the shocking reality of what could lie ahead for them. Crete, in Greece, has got it all. Sun, sea, ouzo and millions of olive trees. Not so long ago, it had one of the healthiest diets in the world, with some of the oldest and fittest inhabitants on the planet. But all that has changed. For a lot of the population, traditional fish and vegetables have been replaced by a meat-heavy, fast-food diet. And active lifestyles are a thing of the past. 1 in 5 Greeks is obese, and Greek kids are some of the fattest in Europe. Amarine and Gary will be staying with the massive Manisaki family, who indulge their 10-year-old daughter on whatever she wants. Their sedentary lifestyle and late-night feasting has sent the family's weight tragically off the scales. Two-stone Vangelis fixes fridges and works 15 hours a day. His Australian-born wife, Elpida, weighs nearly 30 stone, and due to her excessive weight, has serious health problems.
Yeah, that's not like my thing. I can't lose weight, so I don't push myself as much as I should.
Elpida has infected ulcers on her legs from her obesity, and also suffers from apnea, a condition that stops her breathing in her sleep. Her interrupted nights mean she dozes off throughout the day, and normal daily functions are difficult. 10-year-old daughter Jenny is an alarming 19 and a half stone. Like lots of Greek kids, she plays on her computer and snacks all day. Mum and dad pay no attention to nutritional advice, but daughter Jenny is frightened about the future.
Τα βράδια μερικές φορές κλαίω. Και σκέφτομαι ότι μπορεί να πεθάνουμε εγώ με τους γονείς μου.
For the next week, Gary and Amarine will be living and eating with the Manisakis to get a better understanding of what's making the Greeks fat.
The water here is like a lot clearer than Scottish water.
Well, my hope is that I'll be totally immersed in Greek culture and, you know, be called Stavros by the end of the week. That I'm so Greek.
I wonder where they live. Hope it's beside the beach.
After a 40-minute drive from the capital, Heraklion, Amarine and Gary arrive in Tilissos, a traditional Cretan village.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello, Gary.
Gary?
Hello, Amarine. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
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 I speak English, my husband and my daughter don't. Come on in and we'll show you the Cretan hospitality.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
They are massive. The only idea I had of a Greek family was from My Big Fat Greek Wedding. When I saw this family, I was like, they're twice the size.
This is a Grecian drink, I would normally drink. One we have for guests over.
Το ποτό αυτό που πίνετε είναι χαλαρωτικό και θα σας φύγει η κούραση. Ρακί λέγεται.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Γεια σας. Γεια σας.
Καλώς ήρθατε.
Welcome.
Thank you.
That is really strong.
Oh my god, that is strong, isn't it?
Ειδικά άμα ψήφιζαν ακόμα, θα είναι... Ακόμα καλύτερα.
Oh, I don't think I'll be going for a second one.
Cretans are renowned for their hospitality. And to welcome her guests, Alpida's gone all out. She's prepared a snack before dinner.
The cheese is really nice.
Sfogliata a filo. Feta, which is Greek cheese.
Fate
come guardi.
This is just for starters. Gary and Amarine have no idea of the feast that awaits them for dinner. In Greece, it's a special honour to kill an animal for new guests. Vangelis shows Gary what's on tonight's menu.
Τώρα έχουμε ένα ζώο και θα το σφάξουμε.
It's not something I'd love to see, but if it's a cultural thing, then, you know, it's fine.
Goats and sheep are in abundance in Crete, but until recently, eating meat was considered a luxury.
Oh my god. Oh no. Oh, that's going to really put me off my food.
I'm probably going to end up having goat for dinner.
Oh my god. I can't... Oh no, I'm not even going to look at it.
Everything's falling out.
Oh no, don't tell me. Oh.
So is this your own goat?
Ναι. Αυτό το έχω εγώ το κατσίκι από μικρό. Το μεγαλώσαμε μέχρι που έφτασε στα κιλά που έπρεπε να το σπάξουμε τώρα.
Thank you.
Παρακαλώ.
I was like really shocked. I was horrible. I was like, oh no. And I hate blood and stuff, so that was just...
It was a really nice gesture for them to sort of, well, give up something that they've invested in over so much time. I'm quite looking forward to eating something and knowing where it came from.
You know, I'm definitely going to try it. And if I don't like it, I'm not going to eat it, so...
Amarine's put to work in the kitchen while the men butcher the goat.
It's just meat, isn't it, now? It's not even an animal anymore. Seeing the animal being slaughtered, it was a bit like, oh, it's still an animal, but then when we were chopping it up, it's just meat then. It's no different than going to the butchers and asking for a joint. I've brought the dinner.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Do you want to try and find the head for you?
No. Oh, I can see it.
Yes, there.
That's just ghastly.
Despite being one of the leanest meats, Alpida drowns it in olive oil and slow roasts it for a couple of hours.
Just don't eat me, head. How do you say eat? Valde na fate, everybody. You too, Gary.
Gary, pare. Πρέπει να το δοκιμάσεις για να μας πεις τη γνώμη σου.
It's chewy.
Yeah. It tastes like beef.
It tastes like lamb, I was going to say. It just like tastes like lamb. It's all right, I suppose. It's nice.
Dips, cheese and bread are a staple Cretan farm workers have always lived off. And despite being high in saturated fats, sugar and salt, they're still eaten with every meal today.
When you go out, do people just stare at you or...
I always look at the outside appearance, especially here in Greece.
They obviously didn't get to being that size overnight. It's a double-edged sword when I meet people who were bigger than me.